Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
Today, we're going to make a super easy, delicious fat bomb.
But is it chocolate?
It is chocolate, coconut, peanut butter.
And we are going to unveil this recipe right after this.
So if you're new to our channel, welcome. Like I said, my name is Joe.
And I'm Rachel.
And we're Two Crazy Ketos. And here on our channel, we do different things like product reviews. We do recipe videos. We talk about various keto topics. And then once a week, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us on different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we also have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. And that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week. So make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon in that way. Every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
So today we're making a super easy, delicious fat bomb, and you don't even need the oven or stove.
So you say it's super easy, but really, how easy is it?
It's so easy that even Rachel can make it.
Yay! I'm so excited. I've never made a fat bomb like this before.
No, the only kind of fat bomb that you've ever made is our cinnamon roll mug cake, and that's not really a fat bomb. We would just use it as a fat bomb because it's so high in fat. But this one is really good. It's more like a dessert than a fat bomb. But the great part about it is it's super low in carbs.
Ooh.
Even total carbs.
Wow, and for chocolate.
For chocolate.
All right.
So you wanna see what's in it?
Absolutely.
Okay, so first thing we're going to need, obviously, is some chocolate. We're gonna use cocoa powder.
And we use Anthony's, but it's not just because our son's name is Anthony.
No, I just happen to like this brand. All of their stuff is organic. Everything is good quality, so I really like them.
We use Anthony's cocoa powder and we use Caleb's, coconut flour, and we use John's coconut oil.
Actually, it's all Anthony's, but
yeah.
Okay, next, the basis of this whole thing is going to be our coconut oil. Now, you will notice this is white, which is not normal
for our house.
It's white because I put it in the refrigerator because if you can get it into a solid form or more of a solid form, it will help this recipe out a little bit and speed things along.
Well, you should have tricked me.
Yeah, I know, but it's not that cold in this house.
No, it's not.
Okay, so yeah, all you have to do is stick it in the refrigerator for like maybe 5 or 10 minutes before. So instead of softening it, we want to get it hard.
Wow.
Okay?
That's weird.
We need some hemp seeds, some hemp hearts.
Have a heart.
We need some coconut flakes.
Yeah. I'm always like, I need to research this Bob guy. He's in a lot of stuff.
Why?
Like, what's going on there with his hat? Is he like... Looks like he's, you know, I don't know. He's got stories, this guy.
Are you ready?
Yeah, sorry.
We need some peanut butter.
Peanut butter. Now, this is an interesting one that we have found.
Yep, this one is from Aldi's.
It's organic.
This is an organic, and I love this because usually you go into places like Whole Foods and you spend a fortune on getting organic. And here's the best part about this. I paid like $2.29 for this.
Because Aldi's.
Here's the ingredients. Organic peanuts and sea salt.
Doesn't get much cleaner than that.
And honestly, I mean, peanut butter isn't the greatest thing on keto because it can be inflammatory. It's got loads of omega-6s in it.
Well, and but it's not really the best for anybody.
Well, the real big problem with peanuts is peanuts are the most heavily sprayed crop there is, you know, for all the pesticides and stuff. So you really, if you are going to eat peanuts and peanut butter instead of like almond butter or something like that, you really want to try to get organic so that you're not dealing with that. Because although even if it's not GMO, the problem is peanuts are actually grown on the same fields and plantations that cotton is, and cotton usually is GMO.
Yeah, so they're living in the same house.
One way or the other. But here's the nice part about this is, so a serving of this is 2 tablespoons, 16 grams of total fat. It's 8 grams of protein, 7 total carbohydrates, 3 grams of fiber. There's no added sugar.
Wow.
The only thing about these peanut butters is usually you're going to get that big pool of oil, so you're going to have to go in and stir it. And again, the same thing. If you're using a natural peanut butter, which you really want to use a natural peanut butter, get it into the refrigerator to make this recipe so that it's not so thin.
Yeah. Okay? It is a little off-putting when you open up the peanut butter and it's like...
That's because there's no chemicals in it.
I know, but it's weird to start with. Okay. When you're getting used to that, right? Like, it's just a ball of oil in the top.
Now, in addition to peanut butter, we can also use, like I said, almond butter. You can also use this nutso.
Oh, my goodness. That stuff is so good.
And you can use this PB Fit powder.
And we find this everywhere. I think you got this from,
I get it like from BJ's Costco,
or Costco, but I've seen it in Big Lots.
Yeah, they have it in Big Lots. But be careful because some of them are different.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but I like this one. Now, the one thing about this one, when you look at the ingredients on this, this does have peanuts. It does have some coconut palm sugar and salt. But what I like about this one is this is very low in carbs because 2 tablespoons of this, take a look at the carbs on there.
5 minus 3 for fiber, so 2.
2 net carbs, so it's 5 total carbs, so it's a little bit less than regular peanut butter.
Mm-hmm.
And all you have to do with this, if you want peanut butter, is just add some water to it. So
yeah.
You do 2 tablespoons and like 1.5 tablespoons of water, and you end up with peanut butter again. But this
Pretty cool.
A good option if you don't have any peanut butter or if you're afraid to store it. I like having this in the house so that we don't overdo peanut butter itself.
Yeah.
You can also use macadamia nut butter. Just understand that whatever nut butter you use for this, that will change the macros.
And sometimes the PB Fit can get a little pricey.
Yep. So the last thing that we're going to need is some monk fruit. You can also use stevia.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We like monk fruit,
though. I like the monk fruit, but liquid is the best for this. So you either use liquid monk fruit or liquid stevia. So you ready?
I'm so ready.
Okay, so let's push this stuff to the side. Okay, so the first thing we're going to need is obviously a bowl.
These are our favorite.
And we're going to start off with some coconut oil. So you're going to use 1/2 cup. Now, at the middle, if you look in there, is kind of still liquid. So try to scoop it around the outside. You want it to be solid. If it's not, that's fine. You're just going to have to put it in the refrigerator to harden it up after you start.
There we go.
Make sure you don't get too much.
Is that good?
No, we got to level that off.
Like that?
Except for now you got oil over your hands. Okay.
Is that good?
That's good.
Am I good and messy? Like cooking with a little toddler.
I see that. Okay. Go ahead and put that there.
It's greasy.
Okay. You're going to use regular peanut butter.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to go with 4 tablespoons of peanut butter.
All right. Do I need to level off like that?
That's good.
1.
You need something to get it out?
Yeah. Ooh. That's a Rachel scoop. 2. You said 4, right?
4 tablespoons. Let me get you a cup measure for... Just use your finger.
Oop, I'm gonna get really messy.
I saw that. Are you ready?
Nothing to see here.
Okay. 1/3 cup of hemp hearts, and I usually kind of make this like, let it flow over the top a little bit.
Okay. Like that much?
That's perfect.
How many?
1/3 cup. 1/3 cup. Okay.
All right. Ooh, sorry.
And then finally.
It's like slick over here.
You need your cocoa powder. You're going to go 1/4 cup of cocoa powder, but you know what? You also need 1/4 cup. Wait. You need 1/4 cup of coconut, so do that first because then you can go from one to the other.
Okay.
Okay, now we're using the coconut flakes, but you can also use shredded coconut.
This looks like fish food. Like that?
Yep. And now 1/4 cup of cocoa powder.
Is that good?
That's good. And again, I usually weigh everything because this way you get a perfect measurement for your macros, but... Just to save some time, we're not doing that. Finally, you're going to go 20 to 30 drops of your monk fruit or your stevia. So 20 drops is about 1/2 teaspoon.
Okay. Like that?
Yep.
Ooh, look at how golden it is.
Okay, finally, go ahead and mix it all up. Oh, wait, I forgot. We also need vanilla.
Okay.
So wait, I got it over here. So go 1 teaspoon of vanilla. So you've got 1/2 teaspoon measure there. So just...
One.
Just eyeball it. That was not a teaspoon.
You don't want me eyeballing.
You gotta fill it.
Oh.
There you go.
A little.
It's not gonna kill you.
Why is vanilla so expensive?
Because vanilla beans are super expensive, which is why a lot of times we make it ourselves. And it's super
very
easy
time
to make
consuming,
it.
Though.
Yeah, it is time consuming, which is why we have this bottle. We have a batch brewing. But basically, what we have to do is get a bunch of vanilla beans, slice them, stick them in some vodka, and let it sit for 6 months.
We'll have cookies in 6 months, kids. Just sit tight.
I had a batch that was like 3 years old. And then when we moved.
Is that safe?
Yes. When we moved, we lost it. Uh-oh. I was so upset because it was the best tasting vanilla because those beans were just sitting and sitting and sitting.
Well, in 3 years, we'll have some more good stuff.
Okay.
Wow.
You got a good mix?
Yeah, that looks okay. Amazing.
Now, again, we're in South Florida, and, like, we're in the middle of a heat wave. It's been, like, ridiculously hot. Like, it's been a struggle to even keep our house at 75 degrees, yeah. Let alone trying to get it lower than that. Uh-huh. So this is, like, a little bit thin, you can see.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do is we're going to just stick this in the refrigerator for just, like, 4 or 5 minutes and let it defrost and let it thicken up. Not
don't
defrost.
Let it defrost.
And let it thicken up, and then we'll come back and scoop it.
Okay.
Okay? Okay, so we got it out of the refrigerator, and you can see it's a much harder consistency.
Yeah.
Now, I did want to mention, if you didn't want to wait, you don't have to do it this way with a cookie scoop. I just like the presentation this way.
Yeah.
You could have also just taken it and poured it into
mold.
Like fat bomb mold or something like that. So we're going to use a cookie scoop, and we're just going to get as many as we can out. Try to make them all the same weight. That's way too much in one. Because you want to try to have them all the same for your calories and your macros purpose.
Like that?
Yeah, we probably had it in there a little bit too long, but it means they're going to have a better shape when we scoop them out.
Ooh. They remind me of like haystacks.
Yeah.
Is that close?
Those are perfect.
Enough? Oh my goodness.
Just try to keep them all the same size.
Nobody ever says perfect and Rachel cooking at the same time. Oop, he's a little deformed. Look away.
Let's see how many you can get out of this.
I'm gonna try. Definitely the more the merrier when it comes to desserts.
Now, so putting it into the refrigerator, it could be like a blessing and a curse. If you leave it in there too long, it becomes harder to work with and scoop because you got to scrape it off of the side of your bowl. But if you don't leave it in there long enough, trying to scoop it out, you're going to see it's just going to start kind of falling apart and
so
melting.
Is there any way you gauge it, like you eye it?
What I do is I put it in there and after a couple minutes, I kind of go scrape down the edges. And it's just when you get to a consistency that you're like looking to work with. Now, if you start off with like completely solid peanut butter and completely solid coconut oil, you don't even necessarily have to put it in there.
Yeah.
It just depends on, you know, what state your coconut oil is.
That's why we need to keep this house like really cold so that our coconut oil is good to work with, right?
I love the way your logic.
I feel like I'm doing pretty good as far as getting a batch out of this.
You are. Is that it?
I think that's all she wrote.
Okay. Oop. So you got 11 out of these. Mm-hmm. Now I do want to say the nutrition is going to completely vary on, first of all, what kind of nut butter you use. And second, how many we scoop out. So you scooped out 11. So when we come back, we'll go over what the nutrition is on each one of these. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go stick them in the freezer for just like 5 minutes and let them completely solidify. Okay, so it's been 5 minutes. They're nice and hard now, and this is what we're left with.
Feels like it's been 500 minutes because I've been waiting to taste these.
You just want to taste them.
I do.
Well, you're going to have to wait just a couple more seconds because we need to go over the nutrition on these.
You're killing me, Smalls.
Well, do you want to taste them first?
Yes.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Even though we're in the middle of cut down the KetoCon, these things are so low in carb, you can eat an entire one. Okay.
I'm picking this one.
Okay.
Cheers.
Well, like, let me break one in half. I'll take a bite of it.
Mmm.
That's what it looks like inside.
It's so chocolatey.
Is that good?
Mm-hmm. Wow. So chocolatey. I love that. The peanut butter doesn't like slap you in the face. It's almost like it's just helping the chocolate do its thing.
It's in the background.
And the coconut gives it a nice crunch, like a good mouthfeel.
It almost tastes like a Reese's peanut butter cup if you were to take it and mix it all up. Mm-hmm. Very similar to like a chocolate peanut butter ice cream.
Yeah.
And I love the coconut in it because the coconut just gives it a nice texture. Mm-hmm. Now you can even replace the coconut with something else. You can add nuts into it. You can add cacao nibs into it.
That'd be cool.
There's a lot of different things you can do. Let's go over the nutrition on this and then we'll finish our other half.
Yay.
Okay, so again, because the macros are always going to change based on how many you scoop out and what kind of butter you have, what I do is I have my recipe in Chronometer, mm-hmm. and then when we make them, I just go in and make the changes that I need to make. Like one time we only got 9 out of it, sometimes we get 11 out of it, sometimes we get 13 out of it. It all depends on how many you divide up. But based on having 11, each one of these, assuming they all weigh exactly the same, and right. that's what you want to try to do that.
Yeah. Okay?
Each one of them is 172 calories.
Okay.
Okay. It is going to be 16.5 grams of fat each one, only 3.5 grams of protein.
That's awesome.
Okay. 2.2 grams of carbs, total carbs.
That's amazing.
For each one. 1.2 grams of fiber for each one. So that means each one of these is only one net carb.
That's crazy.
Now, yes, there's some protein in there. So somebody may say, well, I don't know how much of a fat bomb it is. Because sometimes you think a fat bomb is having nothing.
Yeah.
But then it's not flavorful, right?
Right.
Each one of these is 88% fat.
I think we're in a safe zone.
So you could even like have a keto brick in this, have your day, and you just ate 1,200 calories. If you want for the end of your last 3 days of cut down to KetoCon.
That doesn't make me
sad. You can eat a keto brick in one of these. You're just about at 1,200 calories and you're a little over about 82% fat per day.
Which is right where I want to be.
Right. And you'll be, if you do the right keto brick, it depends on which one you do. If you do the coconut mm-hmm. or if you do the maple bacon keto brick, you're going to only be at about 11 carbs per day, total carbs.
That's amazing.
So that is our video for today. Let us know down in the comments section if you make these.
Yeah, or if you have any variations.
Yeah,
like if
what
you
are you
going to
change
nuts.
With it? Are you going to add nuts? Are you going to add cacao nibs? Maybe you can even change the flavoring. Instead of use vanilla, use like an almond extract.
Nice.
You can maybe put some slivered almonds around the outside. We've made them all different ways. You know, like every time I do it, I try something different with it. We even use the nutso butter and we're going to give them a little hint.
Okay.
I'm going to go grab it. We're going to try these with a new product that's just come out. And we're giving you guys a preview for a video that will be coming out right after Cut Down to KetoCon.
Yep.
But we just received this to try from the company. They asked us to try it. It's a nutso butter. And take a look at that label.
Keto.
It is a keto version of nutso. Again, this is just a preview. We haven't even opened this. Look, I'm going to take off the top. And you can see
it's still sealed. Yep.
But I'm excited about trying this because listen to the macros on this. I got to put it all the way out here because I don't have my glasses on. One serving, 2 tablespoons.
Nice.
180 calories per serving, 17 grams of fat. We've got 4 grams of protein. And look at the total carbohydrates.
6.
6 total carbs in a serving. And how much fiber?
4.
4. 2 net carbs per serving, and the ingredients in this are coconut, Brazil nuts, almonds, pecans, macadamia nuts, flax seeds, chia seeds, and sea salt.
Oh my goodness.
So keep an eye out. In the next 2 weeks, you're going to see a review of this. It's not even available yet.
Yeah, we're excited because you know that's going to be delicious.
So like I said, that is our video for today. If you like what you saw, do us a favor and hit that like button down below.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time we uploaded a delicious new recipe, you'll be alerted to it.
I'm going to go finish this.
Me too. Until next time.
Bye.
Bye.